Agriculture in Canada is one of the most important and taken for granted industries in our country today. With our easy access to grocery stores containing all the food that we could ever need or want, it's difficult for us to imagine not knowing where our food is coming from tomorrow. Unfortunately, this reality is not shared by everybody else around the world. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, fellow contestants, I've spent the last 3 years at the University of Guelph in a program called International Development. I would describe it as a multidisciplinary approach to improving the lives of people throughout the world, but especially in the poorest countries on the planet. It encompasses issues associated with politics, gender, the environment, and of course, agriculture. This wide array of subject matter has provided me with a very interesting last 3 years, but as I attempt to look beyond the horizons of university life and into my future, I find myself struggling with some of the concepts of international development and their practical applications. I sometimes wonder, who gave us the right in the developed world to point our fingers at the developing world and tell them what they should or should not do? But despite my hesitations, I do see potential in one area of international development that, if conducted sustainably, can have lasting implications all over the world. I've come to the realization that agriculture should be a primary consideration in development work. The production of food is the oldest and most important activity that mankind can take part in. Indeed, it is the foundation of civilization itself. Everybody, regardless of color, creed, age, or gender, needs food to survive. Simply put, a country needs to have a consistent source of food and water before any changes can take place in the environment, governance, or even human rights. Out of the 1.2 billion people struggling to survive on less than $1 a day, 80% of these people live in rural areas and make their livelihoods as subsistence farmers. It is no coincidence that many of these countries are also on the front lines in the battle against treatable epidemics such as cholera and malaria. Without a consistent source of food, these illnesses are nearly impossible to recover from. But for agriculture to be successful in the developing world, the focus must be on creating sustainable, self-sufficient livelihoods that do not allow farmers to enter into a cycle of dependency with other nations. With billions of the world's poor dependent on small-scale agriculture, it is essential that development efforts be focused on these small farms. Seemingly small alterations can have a huge impact. For example, planting trees that convert nitrogen from the air into nutrients in the soil that plant crops can use replaces the need for expensive fertilizers. In addition, the wood from these trees serve as a dependable source of firewood. Basic grain storage facilities allow farmers to sell their grain when the prices are highest, as opposed to immediately after harvest. Small micro projects have the most impact because they're tailored to the unique circumstances of that region. Programs that empower people to find agricultural solutions that foster food sustainability may mean the difference between life and death for subsistence farmers and their communities. So, what is Canada's contribution to international agricultural development? Unfortunately, we have an uneven track record when it comes to this topic. In the 80s, up to 15% of development assistance was allocated to agriculture, but by 2002, this number had dwindled to only 6%. However, renewed interest came in 2003 when the Canadian International Development Agency, or CIDA, launched a new policy called Promoting Sustainable Rural Development Through Agriculture. This new policy was aimed at developing agricultural infrastructure within other countries and include a planned increase of spending from a low of $85 million in 2002 to a whopping $500 million in 2008. For the first couple of years, the results of this project were very, very encouraging. But unfortunately, in 2005, funding was cut again. This meant that many of the projects that were developed under this policy never got to be carried out. Currently, Canada's agricultural spending has halted at around $200 million a year, a far cry from the $500 million proposed in 2003. So what can we do as a country to get back on track? To start with, agriculture must be recognized as a key priority in international development. We need the political will to act on these solutions. This means, in a democracy like ours, you and I need to make it known that we feel that agriculture is important in order to get politicians to act. But why should we as Canadians be concerned with agriculture on the other side of the planet? To begin with, it is said that a hungry man is an angry man, and therein, I argue, lies the problem. We are not isolated from the rest of the world. Helping people feed themselves is essential for creating global stability and peace, and that impacts everybody. If you doubt this, consider the changes that have impacted us all since the terrorist attacks of September 11. Farmers everywhere else in the world are the same as farmers here. It is a universal occupation that connects us on a global scale because it is essential for our survival. The farmer with the oxen plow in Indonesia takes as much pride in his work as the farmer here in Canada with his John Deere 9500 combine. Through agricultural development, Canada has a wonderful opportunity and indeed a responsibility to extend our support to our fellow farmers. And if we can provide them with some tools and resources to work with, we can help these farmers realize their passion and feed their nation. Thank you.